Nirmal Goswami and you are watching Mood India, a program dedicated to the performing arts from the Indian subcontinent. Today we have with us in the studio Shraddha Zobekar. Shraddha is a well-established Bharatanatyam dancer. She has been learning Bharatanatyam and has been performing Bharatanatyam for quite a few years. She has been learning for more than 15 years now. And today she is going to perform on a few songs from Geet Ramayan. Geet Ramayan is the poetic version of the famous epic of Ramayana. She is going to use the style of Bharatanatyam to perform on these songs. Bharatanatyam is the traditional classical dance from South India. So before we start with the dances, Shraddha, can you tell us a little about how you started learning Bharatanatyam?
I was 6 years old when my mother took me to a dance school called as Kala Darshan. There I met my guru, A. Saudamini Rao, with whom I'm for past 18 years.
So you just started because your mom took you there and then you started liking it as you moved ahead with it.
Exactly, because at the age of 6, I guess nobody knows what we're doing.
Absolutely, absolutely. So, why did you feel that you should select Geet Ramayan to perform?
As we know, Geet Ramayan is a Marathi composition written by late Shri G.D. Madgulkar and sung by late Shri Sudhir Farke. It is a composition which propagates Ramayana through poems. And each and every word of Geet Ramayan is important and you can understand it very well. So, I being Maharashtrian, I knew the words well and the songs well. So, I thought that I could choreograph Bharatanatyam well on Geet Ramayan. And the common thing between Geet Ramayan and Bharatanatyam is the nau rasas, the 9 expressions where we have in Geet Ramayan and also in Bharatanatyam.
So, Geet Ramayan is the rendition of the epic Ramayana in Marathi, the language spoken in the western state of Maharashtra. And it is completing 50 years since it has been composed.
Exactly.
And the greatest part is that it is written, I think, how many, 56 songs?
Yeah, it is 56 songs. And the uniqueness of Geet Ramayan is that there's an introductory paragraph before each and every song. And the introductory paragraph is important and also interesting. The words and the lyrics written by our great poet, late Shri G.D. Madgulkar, are so versatile that even a layman can understand the meaning of it. The Bharatanatyam form which we are using here is called as Natya Dharmi. Natya Dharmi, that is a dance drama. Here, we have not changed anything about Bharatanatyam. It is just the way it is. Whatever the adavus are or whatever the expressions are, we use the same thing in choreographing the songs because the songs itself is being choreographed so perfectly that we didn't have any complexes or any problems in choreographing Bharatanatyam in this music.
So you think that this music is in the North Indian, Hindustani classical style.
Yeah, exactly.
And yet you are performing the South Indian dance, classical dance on it. Sure. So you feel that the music was absolutely perfect for this blend. You didn't have to do any changes.
No, we didn't have to do anything.
With, of course, not with the music, but with dance composition, did you have to?
No, we use the same actions, expressions, the adavus. The adavus haven't been changed. Bharatanatyam is an ancient dance, but it can be composed in all the different kinds of music. You cannot restrict it only to Carnatic music. It can be composed in Hindustani and all the fusions. So I guess with the Navrasas, with the Natya Dharmi form, with all the adavus, it was perfect for us to work with Geet Ramayan.
So usually when you perform the whole length performance, you present it as a dance drama instead of just a pure dance form.
Yeah, it's a dance drama because there are each and every characters. For example, Kai Kai, we have Manthara. Then there is Bharat, who is extremely upset because his father is passed away and his elder brother is in exile. So here you cannot we use the dance drama, that is to express each and every character through actions. For example, there is a mudra which shows the birth of Rama. So here we take it as birth.
Okay.
So this is how it is.
So you said that, you know, this is in Marathi language, and from the western state of Maharashtra, that is the language spoken there.
Sure.
And this particular region, the western region, doesn't have any classical dance per se coming from that region.
No, it doesn't have.
So how did the people accept this when you presented it in the classical dance form?
You mean the Bharatanatyam itself,
right,
or
right.
the Geet Ramayan with
Bharat? Bharatanatyam itself. I mean, could they appreciate what you were doing, or because you presented Geet Ramayan in Bharatanatyam, did they understand the dance more?
Yeah. They could understand the mudras better. Because when it comes in a South Indian language, they could not know what is the meaning of this.
Correct.
When we say this in Marathi, that is Mata.
Mm-hmm.
So this people understand that this is called for, used for a woman.
Right.
And for Janak. Now, if we to show this for a king, to denote a king, and this is the way he's sitting on the thorn. So this is King Janak.
Oh, okay. So for any king, you will show it the same way.
This way.
So now people, because it was in Marathi, they could relate that whenever, even if it comes in a South Indian language later on, they can relate that if this is it, then it is a king.
In fact, although I've been learning Bharatanatyam for a longer time, when we compose, my guru and me, when we compose this dance form in Marathi, for Geet Ramayan, I understood the meaning of lot of mudras, which I never knew before. It's not new before to know, but to understand much better. It was very easy.
So I guess the credit is to both the poet and the music composer, because they have come up with such a novel thing, and this is the best time to perform it because it is completing 50 years since it was first composed. If I remember right, it was aired continuously, live airing done on the All India Radio for 1 year, from April 1955 to March 1956.
True.
So that was the first time it was aired. So, you know, Geet Ramayan has this air around it. Do you think people still love it the same way as they used to before?
It is extremely versatile, and the music is so fresh till day to day that in this 21st century also people like to hear it. There is no age bar. It is not necessary that a particular age group likes it. Me being, when we composed Geet Ramayan, I was the age of 20. So I was a new generation, and I loved it. And still day to day, I have my students whom I have taught Geet Ramayan.
Oh, okay.
And they were 18 years old, 16 years old. So they loved it too.
So good. So even kids can learn easily,
absolutely.
I guess, because it becomes audiovisual.
Absolutely.
So since you're presenting an epic, do you still, you know, present it like a Bharatanatyam dance, or do you keep the same costume of a Bharatanatyam dancer, or you change the costumes to depict the characters?
No, we do not change the costume. As we are depicting Bharatanatyam, we cannot change the costume. And as Bharatanatyam has this Natyadharmi form, that is the dance drama form, you cannot restrict it to the costume.
Okay.
Because the lot of mudras explains what you're trying to say. So it is not necessary that your costume matters.
So the costume doesn't matter. Everything goes with the words and your gestures. That's what it is. So let's sit back, relax, and enjoy this beautiful presentation on Geet Ramayana, written by late Sri G.D. Madgulkar and music composed by Sri Sudhir Phadke. Late Sudhir Phadke, who was known as Babuji in all the music lovers. So let's enjoy Geet Ramayana.
Adau Ramat Tapo Vanadigamanam Drutva Mruga Kanchanam Vaidehi Haranam Jatayu Maranam Sugriva Sambhashanam Vali Nirdalanam Samudra Taranam Lanka Puri Dahanam पश्चात रावण कुंभकर्ण हननम एतादि रामायण।
So this was Ramayana in brief, just in 7 lines. What it meant was, Rama went to exile. Sita saw a deer. Ravana came, took Sita away, and on the way killed Jatayu. Rama met Sugriva, the monkey king. Hanumana flew over the ocean. He went to Lanka, destroyed Lanka. And in the end, Ravana and Kumbhakarna were killed. This is Ramayana. Every poet, keeping the same story of Ramayana as the ancient epic, has tried to portray it or put it in front of us in his own unique style. The poet of Geet Ramayana, late Shri G.D. Madgulkar, has his own way of starting Ramayana. He starts out by showing how two young boys, Lava and Kusha, sang and narrated Ramayana in front of Lord Rama himself. Lord Rama had organized a big Ashwamedha Yajna. A Yajna is a religious offering where a fire is lit and prayers are sung and hymns are chanted as an offering. Many people had gathered to witness this auspicious occasion. In this huge crowd, there were these two handsome young boys. They stepped up front and decided that they are going to sing Ramayana. They sang Ramayana in front of Lord Rama. Lord Rama hardly knew that these two young handsome boys were his twin sons, Lava and Kusha. So this is how Lava and Kusha sang Ramayana in their melodious voice.
स्वये श्री राम प्रभु ऐकति कुशलव रामायण गाति स्वये श्री राम प्रभु ऐकति स्वये श्री राम प्रभु ऐकति कुशलव रामायण गाति कुशलव रामायण गाति कुमार दोघे एक वयासे सजीव पुतले रघुरायांसे कुमार दोघे एक वयासे सजीव पुतले रघुरायांसे पुत्र सांगती चरित पिताचे पुत्र सांगती चरित पिताचे ज्योतिने तेजाची आरती ज्योतिने तेजाची आरती कुशलव रामायण गाती कुशलव रामायण गाती राजसमुद्रा वेश मुनींसे गंधर्वचते तपोवनींसे राजसमुद्रा वेशमुनींच गंधर्वच ते तपोवनीचे वाल्मीकीच्या भावमनीचे वाल्मीकीच्या भावमनीचे मानरी रूपे आकारती मानरी रूपे आकारती कुशलव रामायण गाती कुशलव रामायण गाती
Ayodhya was a small kingdom on the banks of river Sharayu. It was ably ruled by King Dasharatha along with his three wives, Kausalya, Sumitra and Kaikeyi. All the subjects were very happy under the rule of King Dasharatha. Everything was going on fine, but there was one thing which was disturbing everybody. None of the queens had any children. On the advice of sages, King Dasharatha decided to do a yajna. He was told that if he does this yajna, he will bear children. When the yajna was performed, from the fire rose a divine being. He had a bowl, a silver bowl in his hand, and the bowl had the divine desert. He rose up, gave the bowl to King Dasharatha and told him that he should give some part of the desert to each of the three queens. Dasharatha did as he was advised, and because of the divine desert, each of the queens had children. Rama was born as the eldest to Queen Kausalya. All the subjects were very happy with the birth of the four kids, and they all sang to celebrate this joyous occasion.
नवमी तिथि गंधयुक्त तरी वात उष्ण हे किति दोन प्रहरी कागशिरी सूर्य थांबला राम जन्म लाग सखी राम जन्म लाग पुत्र दर्शन ओघळे आसु सुखे कंठ दातना ओघळे आसु सुखे कंठ दातना पाक जागता खड़ा काय काय करीत पुना उमलला तुया उच्च रवे वायु त्यास असून बोलला उच्च रवे वायु त्यास असून बोलला ही सुखद जगी पोचली जनी पोचली जनी ये हातून राजपती धावले सुनी धावले सुनी युवतीचा संग एक गात चालला युवतीचा संग एक गात चालला पारलोपले पारलोपले कल्याणचे कंठ तात अधिक कापले अधिक कापले बावडल्या आम्रशिरी मुख कोकिला बावडल्या आम्रशिरी मुख कोकिला नगर सर्व नृत्य गायनी नृत्य गायनी सूर रंग तालयात मग्न मेदिनी मग्न मेदिनी दौलत से ती ही जला शेष डोलला दौलत से ती ही जला शेष डोलला
The four boys were growing up. They took all the lessons which were necessary for them to become ideal princes and later on good kings. They were taking lessons in archery, they were taking lessons in religion and so on and so forth. Slowly they also started attending the royal court. One day when Rama and Lakshmana were attending the royal court with their father King Dashratha, sage Vishwamitra came to the court to ask for help. He pleaded to Dashratha that he should send Rama and Lakshmana to help him. The demons were disturbing and they would not allow the sages in his hermitage to complete their religious offerings. Dashratha wasn't very sure because Rama and Lakshmana were very young to fight with the demons. But the sage was very sure and knew how able they were. And of course, as Lord Dashratha, King Dashratha was, he could not deny the request and he did send Rama and Lakshmana with sage Vishwamitra to help him destroy the demons.
Jeshtha tuja putra mala deyi Dashratha yajna rakshana sayogya koti sarvatha Jeshtha tuja putra mala deyi Dashratha मायावीरा त्रिंचद कष्टविति मदसि फार मायावीरा त्रिंचद कष्टविति मदसि फार कैकवार करुण यज्ञ नाही सांगता केत तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा हा फिरुन यज्ञ आणिति ते फिरुन विघ्न आरभिता फिरुन यज्ञ आणिति ते फिरुन विघ्न प्रकटतात मंडपात प्रकटतात मंडपात कुंभपेटता जेठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा बालवीर राम तुझा देवो त्या घोर सदा बालवीर राम तुझा देवो त्या घोर सदा सानगरी बाळ तुझा थोर योग्यता जेष्ठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा जेष्ठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा का हो सिंद्रपा मुनि मागे राज कृपा शंकित का हो सिंद्रपा मुनि मागे राज कृपा भावर सीताय असा शब्द पाळता जेठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा कौसल्ये रडसिकाय वीरुकशी वीरमाय कौसल्ये रडसिकाय वीरुकशी वीरमाय उभय वंश धन्य रणी पुत्र रंगता जेठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा यज्ञ रक्षणास योग्य तोची सर्वथा जेठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा तो सुबाहु राक्षस ते दीर्घ बाहु मारिच तो सुबाहु राक्षस ते दीर्घ बाहु ठेवितील शस्त्र पुणे राम पाहता जेठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा श्रीरामा तू सम्मान श्रीरामा तू सम्मान घेई तुझे चाप बाण ये तो तर ये गुदे अनुज मागुता जेठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा यज्ञ रक्षणास योग्य तोची सर्वथा जेठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा
So with this, we end today's episode. But we have more of Geet Ramayana coming in our following episodes. So definitely watch. Thank you.
जेठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा यज्ञ रक्षणास योग्य तोची सर्वथा जेठ तुझा पुत्र मला देई दशरथा